Hey, no problem, Dozer. I know that tagging is something that happens out here, and unless it's something really offensive or bizarre, I'm more than happy to participate. So what's your guilty pleasure? I'd have to say food. I mean, that's probably why I'm as big as I am. Pepperoni pizza. And I got to the point now where at least I'm trying to save a little bit of money. I'll get the frozen pizzas, pepperoni pizzas or something like that in the store. And then I'll buy a package of those, you know, the pepperoni that you can buy. And when I go to cook the pizza, I'll load it up with extra pepperoni. And that's my guilty pleasure. What price would you charge if you were a prostitute? You know, when you get to be my age, you kind of think of that in terms of you're lucky if you know, have sex at all. And so the thought that someone would pay me money to have sex with me is about as foreign a concept I could get to. So I'll just answer it like this and leave it at that. Oh, probably a large bag of M&Ms. Who's your best friend? Wow. Who's your best friend? See, I've talked about this a little bit before in other videos in terms of long-term friendships. Because I joined the Navy when I was 17 and moved every 2 or 3 years, of course being in the service, I never really developed long-term friendships. Nor did I ever really learn how to develop long-term friendships. So I'm going to say, and this will be odd for many people, including my wife. She doesn't understand it. She's still convinced that all internet people are axe murderers, potentially. But my best friends right now are internet people, people that I've met through YouTube. There's a couple in England, David and Melissa, who are what I consider to be best friends. And TJ and Solomon and Peggy, I consider to be best friends. Because they are people that I can talk to about just about anything. So I would have to say those folks. Plus there's a lot of other YouTube people that I've met that I feel very close affection for in terms of a friendship. Some of them I've met in person, which of course, you know, that helps solidify some of those friendships. David and Melissa I've never met in person. Of course, Peggy and TJ and Solomon, I got to meet them at South Tube. And there's some other people I met at South Tube or 777. And, you know, it just kind of solidified what I consider to be a friendship, in my own definition of friendship. What's your favorite candy? Refer to question number 2. If someone asked you for a dollar, would you give it to them? I am the world's most terrible person when it comes to people asking for money. It is, I don't know what it is. Maybe it's a failing on my part to be discerning or to be a little bit more cautious when it comes to that stuff. I was walking home from the drugstore right across the street the other day, and this woman was sitting out there with a little girl. She was probably, I don't know, 5, 6 years old. And she said, "Excuse me, sir." And I said, "Yes." And she said, "Would you have a little bit of extra money? I'd like to buy some milk for the kids." Now, there's lots of ways to react to that situation. I could have just ignored it. Sorry. I could have gone back in with her and bought the milk and handed it to her, which maybe some people would suggest. What did I do? I reached in my wallet, and because the only thing I had was a $20 bill, I handed her a $20 bill. She looked at me like I was crazy, thanked me profusely, and took the money and headed for the drugstore. I assumed to buy milk. I don't really know. What did she do with that the rest of that money? I don't know. But in my mind, there's a couple of different ways to look at it. If you're religious, you can look at it from the standpoint that the money's not yours anyway. It belongs to God. God has given you the money. And so, therefore, it's really up to God to determine how to spend that money. And you should certainly be giving something back. If another way to think about it is, if you don't have any religious beliefs, is that if someone is in such a state that they are asking you for money, as humiliating as that can be, maybe not for some folks that do it all the time, but as humiliating as that can be, do I just ignore that? I could, but I don't. So yeah, if someone asked me for a dollar, I would give it to them. Long story made short there. So, anyhow. I guess I will have to, I'll have to think about if I'm going to tag anybody with this video, because I do like to be careful about tagging people with videos. You know, I don't want to make anyone uncomfortable. So, I'll think a little bit. If I decide to tag someone, I'll put it in the description of the video. Anyway, thanks, buddy. Appreciate you tagging me. Talk to you later. I will add something real quick on the end of this video, just so you don't get the idea I'm a complete naive fool. You know, when I was at 777, there was a guy in the park there who asked me for money for food. Now, of course, my first instinct was, I'm in New York. New York is full of professional beggars. And I am aware that there are people that will just professionally beg for money. But I gave him a few bucks so he could get some food. I went walking around the place, and I guess about an hour later he approached me again. And he said, "Excuse me, do you have a few dollars for food?" And then he kind of goes, "Oh, I've talked to you already." I said, "Yeah, you have." And he just turned and walked away. So I do know that there are people out there that will take advantage of if you let them. But I have a tendency to think the best of people until I'm proven wrong. So that's just the way I am, I guess. And probably why I don't have a lot of money. Talk to you later.